Back with a new video, and this is a video about how to fuck up or block your manifestation completely. What I see is that a lot of people do have the right emotions and do have the willpower, but lack the ability to let go. And letting go is very important. You do a ritual and then you place it somewhere, and you're going to pick up where you left off. You're going to walk the dog, do the dishes, bring your kids to school, pick them up again, cook your meals, go to work, mop the floor, read a book, watch YouTube videos, go to the cinema with a friend, go to a restaurant with your husband or whatever, go biking, walk the dog again, cuddle the kids, play with squishies, light a candle, do your prayers, read a book, doesn't matter. You do your ritual with all your power and all your intention, with full focus, and then you let go. You just leave it alone and you just continue life like it's supposed to be, or how you want it to be. Because you're going to fuck up when you are acting like a messed up psychopathic fisherman. When you go fishing, you have a hook that you throw into the water, and then you're going to drink a beer, use an umbrella when it rains, meditate, read a book, enjoy the sun. Doesn't really matter, even if it takes 5, 6, 7 hours or maybe 6 months until you catch a fish. It doesn't really matter, because it's about throwing the hook in the water, have faith, and then wait till the fish is ready to grab onto the hook. And then you can kill it or eat it or let go of it again. But what I see is that a lot of people mess up their magic and manifestations because they are completely confused and obsessed with how magic works. They throw the hook in the water, wait 3 seconds, start looking at the hook, is there a fish on it, throw it in the water, 3 seconds later, is it still, no, it's, and this goes on like forever. And the universe can't take over all the effort you put into this, and can't grant your wishes, because you are constantly interrupting the universe that really wants to work with what you gave it. But throw it in the water, 3 seconds later, throw it in the water, 5 seconds later, throw it in the water, 4 seconds later. And even worse is that people do their ritual with full power, full focus, the right intentions, all their emotions, and they do everything right, and then they are going to sit and stare at the hook. Is there a fish? Is it going to bite? Why isn't it there? What's going on? I did the ritual right. I did everything right. All my hate is in it. All my emotions are in it. If a fisherman goes fishing and it would stay at the side of the pond staring at a hook, a fish in the water is not going to jump out of the water, grabbing onto that hook, thinking, well, this is what he or she wants, so I'm going to bite and just grab this and then I'm ready to die or whatever. So it's something so simple. But apparently, after a lot of comments in my YouTube channel, so difficult, you have to do the ritual with all your emotions, full focus, all willpower, and then you're going to place it somewhere. You're just going to throw it away, place it in the garden, anyway, you're going to let go with faith, 100% faith that your wish will come true and that your manifestation will be there. And the universe, some situations are simple, then you have a few pieces of a puzzle, and the less pieces there are, the easier the universe gets them all together and your manifestation is there. If you are in a difficult situation and are in a lot of trouble, and if you are struggling, then often it's a puzzle with much more pieces, and the universe needs time to put all the pieces together. So you have to do your ritual, put it away, send it away, put it aside, have confidence, have faith, 100%, and then the universe can make your wish come true, whatever the wish is. Maybe you want your neighbor to win the lottery, fine. Maybe you want your enemy to die, fine. Maybe you want somebody in the hospital, fine. Maybe you want to find the right school for your children, fine. But you have to do it with the right mindset, which is let it go. And then you're going to mop the floor, bring the kids to bed, cook a nice meal, go to a restaurant with your friend, go to the cinema with your husband or your boyfriend, or have a cup of coffee with your neighbor, walk the dog, cuddle the cats, do the laundry, go to parties, celebrate life, enjoy nature, dance in the full moon, just start knitting, collect soccer pops or squishies like I do. And I always have my manifestations. That's because I let go after I did a ritual and let the universe take over. But throwing a hook into the pond and pulling it out every 3 seconds to see if there's something on it, it's either nothing or a lost shoe, but it's not your target or your wish that is here. And people sometimes just do the ritual and just stare. Is it there yet? Is it there? No, there's nothing on it. Why does this take so long? I did the ritual, I did everything right, and nothing's happening. That's because you have to let go. Just throw it in the trash, throw it away, bury it in the garden. Just forget about it. Forget all about it, and your wish will come true, and your manifestations will be there. And at some point, maybe 6 hours later, maybe six days later, maybe a year from doing the ritual, you will know that your target's dead in the hospital, completely ruined, or that your children are successful and your husband's rich and your dog is healthy. And that's how you do it. And I already did, I think, 5 videos on how magic feels. So please watch those videos and remember the story of the fisherman. A fisherman just going to enjoy the sun or enjoy the rain or drink a beer, read a book, and or just stare at the water and become totally relaxed. You have to be relaxed, you have to have faith, and you have to have confidence that what you did will be there. But it's only going to happen if you let go of the hook. And at some point you will see that it's dancing around in the pond, and then you will know, I'm there, I did it, it happened. So that's it, see you next time, bye.